Welcome to this presentation on relations and functions. If you're in my class, this comes out of section 4.2. If you're on YouTube, I don't know what section is coming out of your book. But basically what we're going to talk about is three ways to represent relations. There's three ways. You've got tables. Got tables. You've got map diagrams. Map diagrams. DIAGRAM, I think, map diagram, and graphs. So with relations, let's just talk real quick about what a relation is. A relation is an ordered pair. What's an ordered pair? An ordered pair is this, right? So an example of an ordered pair could be 2, 3, 2, 6, etc. Now, a relation could also be a set of ordered pairs, which just means there could be more than one, right? Right here, that's a relation. Now, to put it in a table, let's look at a table first. Table. What does a table look like? Kind of looks like this, right? Over here, that's your x and that's your y value. X is your input, y is your output. Or it's your range, and your input's also your domain. So, input, output. Your x is always going to be on your left, and your y is always going to be on your right. And to remember that, range and right both start with R, right? So, put range down here. So let's talk about this. So you just put your ordered pairs in here. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, right? And then you put your output here. So let's, you got. Let's say this is your speed dial, right? And you're going to, so here's your input. It's going to, and if it's your phone, you're going to push one, and that's going to be your output, this phone number, right? So that could be your BFF, it could be me, that's pizza, and that's the algebra hotline, right? But this is a function because every time you push a number on your cell phone, you get a specific output. So this is a function. Well, what if you had something and you got your BFF, it's still talking about phones, right? Speed dial, speed dial, got your BFF, you got me. So sometimes you push one, you got your BFF, sometimes you got me, you push two. Sometimes you got your BFF. Sometimes you got me. Sometimes you got Walmart. Sometimes you got, your, so you get, the president, right? So that's not a function. Not a function. So with these functions, it's in here. If you wanted, you could have the same, you could put me on all your speed dials, right? That would still work. So, but still, each input is giving you just one output. But here, each input is giving you, wacky outputs, multiple outputs. So that's a table. Let's talk about a mapping. You got, there's gonna be some ovals with some numbers. And that's your input, that's your output, and So for it to be a function, each input can only have one output. Now it's okay for it to, this, you know, it's okay for this 8 to have two inputs. That's still going to work. That's okay. But what you can't have is something that looks like this. If this one gives you more than, if there's more than one arrow, from an input, not a function. Remember that. So each input can only have one arrow for it to be a function. Now this is a relation. It's a relation, not a function. Remember, a function is also a relation. So this is a function and relation. Last way we're going to talk about these in class is graphing, right? So remember this. That's your y, because you can stick it up in the ground. That's your x. So this could be, you know, points. So your y is points. This is, you know, place, right? So first place team would have the most points, right? Second place, third, fourth, right? Even fifth, got no points. But notice each of these is an ordered pair. It could be represented by an ordered pair. And this would be a function. However, not all graphs are going to be functions, because we'll see some graphs later that aren't functions. So we've in this video, we've talked about three ways to represent relations and functions. They are tables, graphs, and maps. And remember, each input can have only one output. And in the next videos, we're going to look in more detail about functions. We're going to talk about the vertical line test, how to write functions, a lot of pretty fun stuff. Hope you enjoy.